Libra placements, Happy New Year. This is going to be for January 7th through the 17th of 2023. Keep in mind that this is general, so not all the messages are going to resonate. If you like information on personal readings, that link will be in the description box. I have restocked my Money and Abundance Oil, which is my most popular, and when I didn't have it, I guarantee you I was not making as much, so it definitely helps. I do have a protection oil, and this works towards negative energy being sent your way. It works as a reversal, as a return to sender, and anytime I have this on, cops will just stay away from me at any time. Even if I'm just on the highway, like, they will not even come near me. We also have your love attraction oil, which is towards, like, platonic self or attracting romantic relationships, and one more for spiritual DNA. This is for anything crown chakra related, anything divination related. It helps enhance your gifts. It will also help with astral traveling and meditation. Information on that will be in the description box. So let's take a look and see what you guys have coming up. The Chariot, Three of Cups. I don't know if I said this already, but I have a Libra only channel below, which I'll be uploading to. So go ahead and check that out. Nine of Cups, Ace of Cups, Six of Pentacles, Temperance Energy, Page of Cups, and the Four of Cups. Okay, here's what I'm seeing. Within the next 2 weeks, the 7th through the 17th, and a little bit after that, you're going to have people vying for your attention. It's like you're going to be in the spotlight, and all the work that you've done within yourself internally, it's now going to start to show outwards. So your appearance is going to change. Some of you might gain weight, lose weight, depending on what it is that you've been wanting. But with the Six of Pentacles, it's like people are taking notice of you. Either you're going out more or you're going to start going out more, and it's just the fact that you're so giving, nurturing, and compassionate. This is also past people that are going to be begging for you back in some way. I know this is true. This has been happening to me. I've been putting my boundaries up though, because with the Chariot, you're moving fast and furiously towards your destiny, and nothing is stopping you. Any blockages that you had, you're just like bulldozing completely through it. Any people that were there to mislead you, or, you know, to kind of steer you in the wrong direction, you've seen these people for who they are. There's been three individuals in your life who have been wearing masks, and you've unmasked each person one by one. And it's almost like you've been a whistleblower in other people's lives, and you've made them reflect on their own actions and how they treat other people based off of how quickly you cut them off. So people have this thing with you where, because you're so nurturing, giving, compassionate, you make people feel like you'll never leave them for the rest of their lives. And then they start to get complacent, and they start to take you for granted. And once you finally make that decision to cut them off, some of you don't even give warning signs. It's just like you wake up one day and you make that decision and you cut them off cold turkey. And it kind of leaves people stunned. And by doing this, it's actually brought you more joy, more happiness, more resilience. You're getting some form of wish fulfillment between the 7th and the 17th. There's been something that you've been asking for, asking the universe for, working hard for, and you're going to get whatever this is. Others of you, this is just more self-love, self-admiration. Be careful if you can still conceive, because this is also heavy pregnancy energy, the Ace of Cups and the Page of Cups together. So if you're not trying to conceive, just make sure you are taking your precautions. With the Four of Cups, there's also someone from the past, an ex, that's going to come back to you. Because of the fact there's so many people vying for your attention, it could be multiple exes at once. But there's one in particular who did you the most dirty. They betrayed you in the worst ways. This is a person that probably caused you the most trauma and the most PTSD in forms of relationships. It's like you've softened this person's heart, because they no longer have access to you anymore. Because you've left them to, you know, the women or the men that they were pursuing, this person's realizing that despite however many options they may have, and this Page of Cups has options, they can have up to four. You're that special cup that they cannot forget. They cannot, they can't just throw the blanket over you and pretend like you didn't exist. The relationship that you had with this person, it's been like a definitive moment in their life, and they did not realize this while they were in the connection with you. But now that you've left them to their demons, to their incubus, succubus spirit entities that they fell for, this person isn't even, they are not even looking in the direction of these cups. So this person's solely focused on you. It's almost like the importance that you have in this ex's life has increased due to your absence. You're also in the energy of creating balance and equilibrium. What you don't know is most people invite you places, or they want to be around you because you have such, like, addicting energy, and people are aware of this, and this is why you get misused and strung along and used, because some people don't want to admit it to themselves that they're not ready for a commitment, or they're not ready for something stable, they're not ready for something, you know, mature, and they know what your standards are. So what they do is they try to confuse you and string you along so that you can't really know where things are headed. And that's essentially your vulnerability, is not paying attention to your intuition, not paying attention to the signs and the red flags that you're being heeded. There's also going to be a celebration that you're going to be invited to, a party, wedding, baby shower, dinner, lunch, it could be anything. And whatever this is that you're invited to, it's going to change the course of 2023 for you in some way. So this could be something as big as you going to this party and you meet someone who ends up being the love of your life, or ends up being a best friend for you for the whole entire year. So whatever this get together is, it will be beneficial for you. And anything that you do get invited out to, try not to say no. Like, try to actually evaluate whether these are people that you want to bring in the new year with. So let me get another deck. That way I can get some additional messages. Nine of Swords, that was in reverse. So any stress, any havoc, any baggage, anything that anyone was bringing into your life that was negative or was affecting you in a negative way, you've released that. You've actually gotten to the point of where you've become a teacher, a guru, a shaman. And with the Hierophant, it's like the course of your life and all of the traumatic events that you've gone through, it's gotten you to this point of where you almost have this infinite amount of knowledge, and you could write books, you could start podcasts. You're the type of person that could draw a crowd. So if you were to join like the political party, you would be somebody that would be a threat, because you just have this way of speaking. Your throat chakra has been activated. You may have been in positions in the past where people tried to stifle you, to get you to shut up, to keep you stuck or bound. And you've almost, it's like your voice is amplified now. And with the Wheel of Fortune, there's also Dharma coming in for you, which is good karma for me. That's what Dharma is. And then karma is kind of like the downside of the Wheel of Fortune. So with the Hierophant and the Wheel of Fortune, you've almost elevated your life in some way. And within the 7th through the 17th, you're going to be clearing out past energies and also attracting new opportunities available to you. So this would be the best time to write down the things that you want, like on a vision board, on a sheet of paper, on a planner, because we're jumping through timelines. Your energy and your frequency is increasing so much that on a quantum cellular level, you're surpassing your peers or the people around you. And you're getting to this point of like union within yourself. You are someone who is aligned. So when you approach people who are in denial about who they truly are, or when you are in environments that aren't authentic, people will start to be standoffish towards you, or they'll try to push you out of the way, or they'll try to bully you. And that's essentially what I see you've been shielded from. You're now at the energy of where you can manifest anything that you want. Wish fulfillment here twice. Also be careful with over drinking, especially because, you know, it is this time of year. But with the Nine of Cups, it's the time for you to have joy, contentment. Between the 7th and the 17th, I don't see anything really that should throw you off your game, except this one person who wants to return to you, this ex, lover, former friend, former colleague, a family member that you no longer have ties to. It's like there's been a permanent ending with you and this person. The bridge has been severed. You don't want this person back in any way, shape, or form. Your life is actually better now that they're not in it, and they're realizing that you were the prize the entire time. This person wants, even if it's just a friendship, even just being able to talk to you, their life is not the same without access to you. And you've actually elevated to the position of strength. All of these are majors. We have three majors here: Strength card, the Hierophant, and the Wheel of Fortune. So you're going through the life of studying. It's like you're collecting data and knowledge as you go through these lessons and cycles with people. And this was all intentional to get you to a place of where you're going to have a podium. So if this is not a YouTube channel or some form of platform online, you're going to get to a position of power where your word is going to be law. Like, this is almost like a judge. It's giving heavy judge type of energy. And with the Strength card, this is also about the Pope dying, which it's going to benefit the world in other ways. I don't know why they brought that up, but okay. with the Five of Swords to the Strength card, you having strength and resilience and walking away from these people that don't serve you, these people that had ill intentions for you in the first place, you have a tendency of attracting like liars, manipulators, shapeshifters, people that are beggars, mooches, opportunists, and some of them have been successful at like draining you of your light and your love and your time. And even though this could have been detrimental to you, in the long haul, the things that you've learned are not only going to benefit you, but also mankind in some way. Because just like me, what I went through, I opened up my YouTube channel, and now I can help all of you and give you guys the keys and the tools to be able to assist your own lives. Same thing here as well. With the Knight of Cups to the Ten of Swords, this past person that did you wrong, I can see up to three people. A friend that was intimidated by you, envious of you, tried to be you, be a doppelganger of you, tried to pursue all of your exes. A friend, and then we have a family member that you thought you could trust, that you found out was speaking ill about you, spreading lies, gossip, and then a third person is an ex. This ex betrayed you in all ways. They may have even abused you sexually, emotionally, sorry, trigger warning, I should have said something, but the ways that this person betrayed you, there's something unforgivable that happened here. And their life, the fact that their life has been going in a downhill or a downslope is a direct reflection of the things that they did to you. So this Knight of Cups is going to try to come in to give either an apology, to try to mend things, to try to say, you know, bygones be bygones. Do not go back to this person. They have some sort of negative attachments that they've picked up from their own choices in life, as well as partners that they slept with. And if you take this person back in any way, your blessings are going to get blocked 100%. Do not let anybody from the past return to you. Sure, you could hear them out. Sure, you could accept the apologies. But if you go back to the past, you're going to get put right into the rotation with these three other people, even though you are the greatest cup of all. So if you're the type of person that has a tendency of not getting chosen by people, they don't choose you because they know it takes work to be with somebody like you. You're somebody who has standards. You're not just going to take any type of treatment. So what people will do is they'll go and find somebody who's weaker, who has less standards, and try to make that situation work. And that's essentially what could have happened to you. But it's a blessing in disguise. So January 7th through the 17th. Can I get something new because I'm tired of the past and seeing the past and hearing about it? Justice, Four of Wands, Three of Swords, the Hierophant, yet again, Seven of Swords, Page of Swords, Nine of Swords, the Devil. Okay, so you're going to get a test. A test from the Devil and a test from the Divine. So the Devil is going to bring someone back from the past that you really wanted. This is someone that you have a strong draw to. This is someone that you didn't really have a relationship with. It was kind of just like a talking stage and it didn't really get anywhere. But this is someone that you're highly attracted to physically. It's like they check all your boxes on all the traits that you look for in a person. However, this is someone that you somewhat be settling with because they're not on your level and they're not on your vibration. And they have some sneaky ways about themselves. This isn't an ex because you never actually had anything solid with them. This isn't someone who you've had a commitment with. It's just a past person that you were attracted to. They're coming back. You could have this person if you want them. If you want to have a relationship with them, you can get that. If you want to pursue something sexual or just casual with them, you can get that. However, by you feeding into this temptation, it is going to be you feeding into the devil aspect in some way, because the devil can be lust, it can be greed, temptation, anything that you're not doing in moderation. And this is someone that I feel in the past did not see your worth. And the divine wants to basically test you to see, will you accept what you used to be into? And will you allow yourself to be taken down a path that could lead you to stress? This is going to be a person who's not really going to tell you where the relationship is going. They're not going to tell you what their intentions are. They're going to try to play this guessing game with you. Because as long as this person doesn't tell you or show you what their intentions are, they get the upper hand. And so with the Nine of Swords, just be aware of anyone new. And I know this is true because I've been attracting new people, but it's almost like carbon copies of old scenarios, or it feels almost like the same person or the same soul in a different body. And this might be the case here as well. If you have a tendency of attracting wishy-washy, inconsistent cheaters, polyamorous people, or people that just wanted to string you along, well, you're going to get someone who's going to be really, and it's going to be really hard to deny this person. But once you deny them, then you get this solid commitment coming in within a month. So the first half of you are going to fall for whoever this page of swords is, because they're attractive. Like, even just me reading this, I'm like, oh man, this person's attractive, but I know they're not for me. But am I willing to put myself in that scenario? 50% of you will. 50% of you will fall for this person, and they could take you through a cycle that's going to last up until August or September. So this person could possibly string you along for an entire 9 months if you let them. However, if you heed to the signs and the red flags and you really pay attention to your intuition, because your gut's going to tell you that something's off about this person or the situation, but you're not going to have any solid proof. There's not going to be any physical evidence that's like in your face to tell you that this person is deceiving you. So if you fall for the first option that comes in, you know what you're getting at. Sadness, betrayal, stress. And if you hold off and you allow yourself to heal, because some of you are just like impatient. You're like, where's my person? Where's the person that, you know, I can build with? And you're almost like too eager to jump into situations, but you really need to wait out. With justice, anyone that did you wrong, best believe they're definitely getting their karma right now. And this could be up to 7 people between 2019 to 2022 that have really caused you some form of like harm or detriment or tried to block your blessings in some way. You're going to have a stable 2 weeks. This is also you feeling good in your home, like being able to maintain your house, decluttering, and allowing yourself to heal. And knowing that you are fully supported. Some of you are thinking about going back to school or just having a advancement in education, like taking extra classes. This is going to be beneficial to you as well. So let me get another deck. That way I can get some additional messages for Libra placements. What do you guys need to know at this time? Page of Swords, 7 of Pentacles. Wow, they brought this person up again. That's how you know. Okay, so this Page of Swords came out twice. Whoever this is that is about to come into the mix for you, oh man, it's going to be so hard to fight this person off. But if you stand firm on your boundaries, on exactly what it is that you're willing to tolerate, you will see quickly that this is not someone that's aligned with you. With the Page of Swords though, look, they're gonna invest in you. They're gonna call you every day, text you, try to see you. This is someone who's gonna pursue you on a consistent basis. That's why it's gonna throw you off, because you're gonna be like, well, if this person is putting effort in me, time, energy, calling me, coming to see me, taking me out on dates, then why would I not choose them? But it's like the devil's in the details. You really have to pay close attention to this person, because they're the step right before the true love comes in. Because if you look at this Page of Wands, the Page of Swords is someone who's intelligent. This is someone that reads books often, or they just have a lot of knowledge within themselves. So they know how to draw people in. They know how to get you hooked, right? You don't take that trap. Here comes this new person, and this new person is truly healing. This is someone that's actually sent to you from the divine. Look, the star energy is someone who is supposed to be in the public eye, but it's like a true healer. So your person is someone who's healed and is a healer just like you. They're going to give off this strong vibration and frequency just like you. But yeah. You're just going to have to pick and choose. And there's also going to be 2 people from the past that are going to give you some form of apology, or they're going to try to come back around and spin the block. This friend, this Knight of Pentacles, is a friend who you invested a lot of time and energy into, and you found out that they were never truly supportive or even, you know, truly your friend in the first place. And this person's going through it. So the former friend that wants to come in and consolidate or reconcile, they're currently going through it right now, because you haven't been in their life for a long time. They don't have that support that they used to. 1 second. So with the Two of Pentacles and the Knight of Swords, be aware of anyone that makes you feel unstable. Be aware of juggling. If you're going to be single and you're going to deal with multiple people, do it the honorable way. You know, don't try to string people along, because you are going to have options. Anywhere from 2 to 3 options, but I don't feel like these people will come at the same time. I feel like you're going to go through a step with one person. Some of you will get stuck in this relationship because it's easy. I can even see it myself that this would be a trap, but I've already gone through this scenario 2 months ago, so I already know how to guide you guys. And with this Page of Wands, this will be someone who's actually meant for you. They're going to be very attractive. The same way the Page of Swords is, but this will be someone who's more grounded in their energy. They know what they want. They know what they're looking for. They've been someone who wants something committed. So if you don't want something committed, it's just explaining that to the individuals you were connected to. Last but not least, for Libra placements, what do you guys need to know? For the 7th through the 17th. Refuses to take ownership and accountability. They hate you and it's jealousy. Dark magic, evil spells, and Kiss Me Softly. So yeah, people are just so fond of you. The ones that you've encountered, even just like on a friendship level, on a level for love, they cannot forget the type of energy and love and effort that you put into them. And this is why they're so desperate to get back in. We have Illuminati systems, secret society, and Masons. So, okay. Just like how you're a light worker and you're somebody who gets divine messages or downloads, or you work to spread love and light, you have people on the opposite end that kind of get their energy from inflicting fear or pain, sorrow, misery. This is the type of partners or partnerships that you tend to attract. It's like at the core level, they're not aligned with you because they, I don't want to say they worship something else, but they're just, watch out for traps. I just get heavy pain. Whoever this person is, ooh, if they can get you trapped, yeah, I'm not even going to put that into the air. We have refuses to take ownership and accountability. So anyone in your life or anyone that approaches you and they're not accountable in aspects in their life, pay attention to that, because they're not going to be accountable with you either. With they hate you and it's jealousy, you inadvertently attract a lot of hate and jealousy into your life. And this is reflected in your relationships as well. Some people want to get close to you just so they can get access or a ride on your coattail to success because they can see that you're successful. And we also have closet racist and prejudice. So you as a person shift and break paradigms, because whatever prejudices that people usually have for the type of person that you are, it's like you break societal norms and you change how people view just people and human beings in general. Like if someone doesn't believe in love, they encounter you. They encounter like the effort that you put in people, and you completely shift how they see life altogether. With the Seven of Swords and the Page of Swords, also be aware of like gossip coming in. If you do hear some sort of gossip and it upsets you, just know it's probably a lie. Someone's just trying to stress you out. And with the Four of Wands to the Three of Swords, this is all about you focusing on your own goals, your own dreams, putting the time and effort into you, your household, your children, working on yourself, and knowing that you have great things coming to you as long as you heed the signs. So yeah, like, share, subscribe, leave me a comment. Happy New Year again to you guys. And thank you so much for the support. I really appreciate it. Have a good rest of your night or day. Bye.